Well, good morning and welcome back to Log Cabin Firewood. My name is Jack and thank you so much for tuning in today. Today on the channel, we're gonna go finish the cherry next door, and I'm also going to talk a little bit about the Solidur chainsaw pants that we purchased. I wanted a little bit something more than chaps, so I shopped around and asked a couple buddies and they said try these, and they were actually a little affordable. Still a little pricey, but affordable. Let's check it out. So my neighbor actually has to get a bunch of the stuff cleaned up where I have that cherry stacked up. It's actually adjacent property. It's the mining company that's behind all those properties. It's their property, and I think they're going to come through and cut a road in to gain access to future mining over there. The neighborhood's fighting it, so hopefully they can fight it and postpone it again for another decade like they did back in 2011. We'll see what happens. I mean, it is their property, and they do own the mineral rights. It sucks. It's unfortunate because there's hundreds of acres back behind his house. My neighbor that I have my cherry is literally across the road there. I mean, he's got 17 acres, but there's hundreds of acres back there. And my neighbor next door is getting his house done. Roof's up, walls are up. They're in there doing a little bit more stuff. But I'm going to get these pants on because I'm not going to change in front of you. And I also got suspenders. We'll see how fancy they look. And we're gonna go across the street and finish this cherry. So first impressions of the Solidur Comfy Chainsaw Pants is they are very comfy. The name is actually how they feel. I mean, I've got complete maneuverability in these. They have an awesome gaiter with a lace strap in here to keep everything down over your boots to prevent chips and stuff. And if you're, I guess if you're climbing with these, you know, it would prevent the leg from coming up on you. Both sides have that. They've got a front pocket that is Velcro, and it has two different pockets in here. I guess you could put, you know, a cell phone or something in there, or maybe a trauma kit, tourniquet, whatever. The pockets are zippered to keep chips and stuff out, and they're deep pockets that my fingers are right there. It comes all the way down. I did opt to get the suspenders with them. I don't know how cool I look, but I feel comfortable AF. In the back here, along your butt and the inside of your thigh, you do have, I don't know what material it is, but it's super breathable. Like, I could feel the air coming through the pants here, especially when I move, you can feel it. And a lot of people, a lot of complaints I've heard from chainsaw pants is they're very hot. It's 80 degrees today. It's super humid. Right now I feel good. I'm going to fire the saw up and we'll talk a little bit afterwards about how I really feel about these, you know, after working with them for a little bit. And I will make sure that my zippers are down, but this one will be up. That way, sawdust doesn't get in my pockets. You know, there's people that have commented on my channel about how I could have saved diesel fuel and time and not used as much equipment and loaded this stuff by hand. Well, here we go. I just loaded that by hand, and I'll tell you what, it's a lot easier using a piece of equipment. Here we go. Let's get the 500i fired up.
Mm-hmm.
So the reason I just cut a bunch of cookies, let's see, there's one, two, that one's junk, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. We got one, oh, that one's crooked, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9. I need to cut one more. A buddy at work, his daughter is having a like a rustic wedding, and he asked me to get him some cookies, and I told him, I said, I will cut these for you, and he'll have to get his palm sander out and sand the top out, or however he wants to, and then seal the one side. But I'm gonna cut him one more and get him 20 of these, and hopefully they work for him. And so far, these Solidur pants, They're super comfortable. Like, I have no complaints at all. None whatsoever. Definitely worth the, I think I paid $215 for them with a discount. Now we can start cutting some firewood. So just ran the first tank of fuel through the saw. I don't really run on like bone dry, so I ran 3/4 of a tank through there. I don't like running my saws dry because when you run them dry, it sucks any dirt or anything you might have in the bottom of your tank right into your carb, or for me, my injectors. But I'd probably say I'm almost halfway through this pile, and I'm still using the Echo Red Armor 2-cycle mix for my gas with 91 non-ethanol fuel. And right now I am using Mystic that I bought 3 years ago. I bought like 8 gallons of it. No, I bought 10 gallons of it 2 years ago, and I'm still going through it. I bought it at like $8.99 for 2 gallons. But yeah, Chris in the woodyard actually suggested the Mystic stuff. I know here lately there's a lot of people on Facebook talking about the county line stuff being really cheap at Tractor Supply, like $4 or $4.99 a gallon. Hey, get the cheap stuff when you can. It still works. You might have to use a little bit more of it because it's thinner, but whatever. We'll be right back. got everything cut up except for the two pieces that were placed for runners. And as strong as I might think I am, I'm gonna fire up the Sani with the little claw on it, the grapple, and I'm gonna load my trailer up. Here we go. Well, that is the end of the cherry pile. We got everything cut up today. Let's check it out. So this is probably about the same size of load as we had on the first one. And if you watched my previous videos, you know there was about four and a half face cords in the other load. So I'm gonna guess there's another four and a half face cords here. And that will put me right about three cord. So we'll get home and get this stuff dumped. Probably split it next weekend, and then we'll get a good tally on what we've got here. Talk about these Solidur chainsaw pants that I really like. Super comfortable. Like, I can't even tell that I'm wearing chaps right now. All right, well, we got the cherry dumped, guys. As far as these Solidur pants, I think they are a 10 out of 10. This was definitely one of my favorite purchases this year. Yes, they are heavy. Heavier than, like, you know, the regular thin pants that I wear in the summertime. And, I mean, you could tell you've got some chaps on, obviously. But as far as breathability, these things are really good. I think they're a nice addition to my personal protective equipment. If you're not wearing chainsaw pants, you should at least be wearing chaps. It's one thing that YouTube has shown me, and even working for who I work for, you know, PPE is a big issue. So definitely take care of yourself and protect yourself, because there are loved ones that need you and rely on you. So I was actually talking to Matt from Lily's Farm and Firewood, and he was the one that suggested another pair of these. It wasn't the Comfy. These are the Solidur Comfies. His were the next step down. They're a little bit cheaper than these, but they didn't look like they had enough, like, knee. Like, these looked like they had more. I can't compare them for you because I don't have them, but these just looked better in my opinion. So I picked these up at Bartlett Arborist Supply online. It's bartlettman.com. And go check them out if you guys are interested in some chainsaw pants. I think from an affordability standpoint, I think these do a good job. There's a lot of chaps out there or pants out there that can get, you know, $400, $500, $600, $700. And I am looking into getting a pair of chainsaw boots. That's something I'll probably get at a show, because I know you can sometimes get some show deals. Hopefully, you know, fingers crossed. But yeah, definitely check these out. 10 out of 10 recommend them. I'm in no way affiliated with Bartlett. I did purchase these with my own money, but if I'm going to buy stuff and I like it, I'm going to tell you that I like it. It's a good thing about me is I don't have any paid promotions. You know, the stuff that I have is the stuff that I worked hard for and I bought. And some of the stuff is a want. It's not really a necessity, but, you know, I buy it anyway so I could show you guys, you know, different options. But yeah, check it out, guys. Bartlettman.com. But that's going to be it for today, guys. I hope you all have a great rest of your weekend. Great rest of your week. Stay safe. Take care of each other. And I will catch you back here next Saturday at 6:30 a.m. Thank you so much for watching.